الحمد لله رب العالمين، الحمد لله تعالى، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهدي الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. Indeed, all praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our Lord, the gracious, the merciful, the master of the earths and the heavens, the king of the day of judgment, Azza wa Jal. And the prayers and the blessings of the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala be upon our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and be upon all those who follow in the footsteps of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Nashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah, wa nashhadu anna Muhammadan abdullahi wa rasuluh, وصفيه من خلقه وخليله صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وصحبه ومن استنى بسنته وسار على هديه إلى يوم الدين. Indeed, we bear witness that there is no Lord but the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is indeed the messenger of Allah. I remind myself and remind you to be pious, to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in everything that you do, to heed the calling of the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala when He says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ حَقَّ تُقَاتِهِ وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَلْتَنْظُرْ نَفْسٌ مَّا قَدَّمَتْ لِغَدٍ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ. Oh, who you believe, be God conscious and die in no way except in the way of Islam. Oh, who you believe, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and let every soul be aware of its own tomorrow, and fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for He knows best what you do. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to instill taqwa in our hearts and to keep our feet steadfast on His path, to forgive our sins and guide our steps and accept our prayers. Allahumma ameen. My dear respected brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in so many places reminds us and orders us to remember the value of the time we have onto this earth, the time that passes, the years that go by. Every day that passes is one day less you have on this earth, and one less chance for you to be closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swears by time, وَالْعَصْرِ إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرٍ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْحَقِّ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ, swears by the importance of time, but gives us a very important reminder that you are at loss, except if you know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and believe in Him, if you engage in righteous deeds, if you work collectively, invoking patience and reminding one another to remain perseverant. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that we have not been created in vain. أَفَحَسِبْتُمْ أَنَّمَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ عَبَثًا وَإِنَّكُمْ إِلَيْنَا لَا تُرْجَعُونَ. Do you think that you have been created in vain and that you shall not return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us everything counts. Every action that we do will be counted either for us or against us. فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ دَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَى وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ دَرَّةٍ شَرًّا يَرَى. And so my dear brothers and sisters, if we look at our beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he constantly reminds us to cultivate our time and to remember its importance. He tells us that the legs of a servant will not be shaken. لا تزول قدم عبد يوم القيامة حتى يسأل عن خمس, عن عمره فيما أفناه وعن شبابه فيما أبلاه وعن ماله من أين اكتسبه وفيما أنفقه وعن علمه ما عمل به. And then he warns us, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he tells us, your life? What have you spent it in? Your youth, your strength, what have you done with it? Your health, what have you done with it? Your money from which you have gained and in which you spent. And then the knowledge you have gained, what have you done with it? And lastly, he reminds us, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he says, بَادِرُوا بِالْأَعْمَالِ الصَّالِحَةِ فَهَلْ تَنْتَظِرُونَ إِلَّا غِنًا مُطْغِيًا أَوْ فَقْرًا مُنْسِيًا أَوْ مَرَضًا مُفْسِدًا أَوْ هَرَمًا مُفَنِّدًا أَوْ مَوْتًا مُجْهِزًا. What are you waiting for? Why haven't you done everything that you're supposed to do? Are you waiting for a wealth that will make you forget what's needed to be done? Or you have the risk of doing that. Or a loss of wealth that will make it hard for you to remember to do the good things. Or an illness that will hold you back and prevent you from doing good things. Or an elder age that will take away your energy and your strength to do that which pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Or your death that will complete your time onto this earth. My dear brothers and sisters, when we look at time, the scholars, when they talk about it, they talk about something called wajibul waqt, or ibadatul waqt. The timely worship, the importance of time, not just as minutes and hours that pass, but rather as a mission to be completed, a responsibility to be done. And that's why the scholars say that people, when it comes to their worship, there are two types. Abdun muqayyad, alladhi qayyada nafsahu bi'ibadatin mu'ayyana fi awqatin mahduda la yughayyiruha mahma taghayyarat ad-duruf wal ahwal. Wa 'abdun mutlaq, yattabi'u mardat Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala aynama kanat fil waqti wal hal. فإذا رأيت العباد رأيته معهم وإذا رأيت المجاهدين رأيته معهم لا يكون عمله على مراد نفسه بل على مراد ربه سبحانه وتعالى. We're not talking about just taking use of your time. We're not talking about just paying attention to the time that passes, but rather that's a given. Nobody should not take care of himself and his time. But there is a difference even in those who want to devote their time for ibadah and for the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Some takes things for granted. Some think that it's just a matter of doing the rituals that you're supposed to do or doing the basic requirements that you're supposed to do. And that's a good start, but it's not sufficient. When the scholars talk about what's called ibadatul waqt, awajibul waqt, they say if the ibadah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hiya ismun jami' li kulli ma yuhibbuhu Allah wa yardah min al-af'al wal-aqwal al-zahirati wal-batina. Our definition of ibadah is it's a collective name that contains everything that pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Says, actions, apparent or not apparent. But then the Imam Ibn al-Qayyim fi in kitabihi Madarij al-Salikin, he says something more. He says, إِنَّ لِكُلِّ وَقْتٍ عِبَادَتَهُ وَإِنَّ أَفْضَلَ الْعِبَادَةِ الْعَمَلُ عَلَى مَرْضَاتِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى فِي كُلِّ وَقْتٍ بِمَا هُوَ مُقْتَضَى ذَلِكَ الْوَقْتِ وَوَظِيفَتَهِ. Then it's not just worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the time, but gaining the insight and the realization that there is an importance and a priority to every time to be implemented. And so when you take on the action of worship, you take it to make sure that it is befitting of the reality you live in. And it's befitting of the priorities that take place. And one that is compatible with the necessities of the time. So you don't find the Imam of the Haram talking about a nafila when the Aqsa is being taken over. You don't find a person spending the time to do dhikr, even though dhikr is very important, when his brothers and sisters are homeless or unable to take care of their very basic needs. You must learn to do both. You must learn to prioritize. And so when we look, my dear brothers and sisters, at the essence of this ibadah and the importance of making sure that you inculcate the priorities of your da'wah, of your understanding, of your deen, with the very concepts of everything that you do in ibadah, you find yourself gaining six benefits that are very important. One is you learn to organize your time and to recognize that your time on this earth is very limited. And if you don't become efficient, and if you don't maximize the good that comes with it, then you are at loss. Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu used to say, مَا نَدِمْتُ عَلَى يَوْمٍ أَوْ مَا نَدِمْتُ عَلَى شَيْءٍ أَشَدُّ نَدَمًا عَلَى يَوْمٍ غَرُبَتْ أَوْ غَرُبَتْ فِيهِ شَمْسُكْ نَقُصَ فِيهِ مِنْ أَجَلِي وَلَمْ يَزِدْ فِيهِ مِنْ عَمَلِي. They were so cognizant of their time, they say, that the worst that I would be remorsed about is a day that passes in which I know my life on this earth has been lessened by one day, yet my actions have not been increased by any. That's why when we talk about reminding us of death, people think it's a somber reminder. It's not. It's a reality. أكثروا من ذكر هذه من الدهر. Remember, why? They say, من فوائد ذكر الموت, إيش؟ تعجيل التوبة ونشاط العبادة وقناعة القلب. When you remember your finality, you realize that your tawbah has to be today, not tomorrow. And the good deeds that you want to maximize in, you don't wait until another time. You do it right now. And the contentness of the heart that is necessary for you to be in peace and harmony fills your heart. من أصبح وهمه الآخرة جمع الله له أمره وجعل غناه بين عينيه وأتته الدنيا وهي راغمة. ومن أصبح وهمه الدنيا إيش فرق الله عليه ضيعته وجعل فقره بين عينيه وَلَمْ يَأْتِهِ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا مَا قَدْ كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَهُ. So this is, when you realize the seriousness of that time, it becomes a matter of making sure that you are حَاسِبُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ قَبْلَ أَن تُحَاسَبُوا وَزِنُوا أَعْمَالَكُمْ قَبْلَ أَن تُوزَنَ عَلَيْكُمْ. It is no coincidence, my dear brothers and sisters, that people who work in movements and try to teach the youth to do the right thing, we think we have things as simple as keeping an account. A checklist. هل صليت الفجر في جماعة؟ هل قمت بالأذكار؟ هل تصدقت اليوم؟ هل زرت مريضا؟ هل قمت بعمل خير؟ Every day there's a checklist that you follow until you do your dua before you go to sleep. And you do what's called ورد المحاسبة and so on and so forth. So learn to hold yourself accountable. Secondly, you learn to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the way He Most High subhanahu wa ta'ala wants, not the way you want. تَعْبُدَ اللَّهَ عَلَى مَرَادِهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى لَا كَمَا تَهْوِي نَفْسُكُ فَتَتَعَلَّمَ أَنَّ الْإِسْلَامَ رِسَالَةُ حَيَاةٍ وَلَيْسَ طَرِيقَ مَعِيشَةٍ. Ya ikhwa, when you pay attention to your time, if you don't realize the importance of prioritizing the responsibilities within the time allotted to you, you will allow things to pass on. And you will lose sight of what's important or what's more important than that which you think is important. But if you gauge it with how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's will is in your life, you learn to recalibrate. What matters in this moment, in this place, in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Is it for me to be in the forefront of fixing my society's problems? Or is it for me to enjoy my time with my children and take it easy and go to the park and have a picnic? Neither is haram, my dear brothers and sisters, nor are they things not to be done. But that deep sense of awareness of what's important makes you realize that unless you do everything that is most pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not more pleasing, then you become in a constant state of awareness that allows you to maximize. Thirdly, as we said, You learn to prioritize. You learn to figure out what is more important than the important. Because if you keep yourself busy and you learn to do good things constantly, one of the blessings that comes with it is being busy always with good things, with important things. But then you go to a higher level. Then you go to where you start making sure that you're doing the more important things. And so that you can maximize the benefits that you have from your time onto this earth. Fourthly, you become more practical. You're looking for action. You're looking for results. You're looking for things that are true accomplishments. Then you become true to the word that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made us for. كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ أُخْرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ وَكَذَلِكَ إِشْ جَعَلْنَاكُمْ أُمَّةً وَسَطًا لِتَكُونُوا شُهَدَاءَ عَلَى النَّاسِ وَيَكُونَ الرَّسُولُ عَلَيْكُمْ شَهِيدًا. This responsibility of being a witness of mankind means you have to be in your best shape at all times. لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنًا لِمَنْ كَانَ يُرِيدُ اللَّهَ أو لِمَنْ كَانَ يُرِيدُ لِمَنْ لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنًا لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُو اللَّهَ وَالْيَوْمَ الْآخِرِ وَذَكَرَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا. So it's the path to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that constantly allows you to ensure that you accomplish and that you don't be somebody who just goes with the flow. Fifthly, you realize your time is limited, so there's no time for you to be on the sidelines. There's no time for you to watch the wrong take over the good. And for injustice to happen at your watch. And for you to give up in your responsibility of being a witness to it. You know, the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when they met with him in their final meeting in Medina or in Mecca before they went to Medina, they had a meeting with him when he said, they told him, O Prophet of Allah, tell us what you want us to do and what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prescribes upon us. And he will tell them, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ashtaritu li rabbi an tusaddiquhu wa an la tushriku bihi shay'a wa ashtaritu li nafsi an tamna'uni mimma tamna'una binhu anfusakum wa amwalukum. Qalu wa ma lana ya rasulallah? Qala lakumul jannah. Qalu rabuhal bay'ah la nuqilu wa la nastaqil. When they realized the importance of their time and the importance of their mission and responsibility, they told the Prophet ﷺ two words. La nuqil wa la nastaqil. We will not change. Nuqil, naql, you move things around. And nastaqil, and we won't give up. We will not give up our responsibilities. And so those who understand their time to be their pathway to the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not give up trying hard to maximize the good that they can do. That's why Musa alayhi salam would say in the Quran, وَعَجِلْتُ إِلَيْكَ رَبِّي لِتَرْضَى. Yahya alayhi salam, يَا يَحْيَا خُذِ الْكِتَابَ بِقُوَّةِ. One of the amazing stories in the Battle of Uhud, a man, his name is Wahb ibn Qabus al-Muzani. Maybe most of us may not know him. A young man was fighting with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When the heat of the battle was coming more and more, a group of attackers were coming to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he would say, من لهذه الفرقة? Who would take up those who are attacking us? And this man would jump and he say, O Prophet of Allah, Ana laha. And he would throw his arrows until they back off. Yet another group comes in at another time. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says, Man li hadihi al-katiba? Fayaqul, Ana laha ya Rasulallah.
فيقوم فيذبها بالسيف حتى تولي. A third time, another group comes on, and the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم would shout, من لها؟ فيقوم وهب. فيقول له صلى الله عليه وسلم قم فابشر بالجنة. فيقوم مسرورا وهو يقول يا رسول الله لا أقيل ولا أستقيل. He was the offspring of the same Sahaba who met with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, who when they realized the importance of their timely worship, their timely commitment to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, their words were لا نقيل ولا نستقيل. Lastly, my dear brothers and sisters, when you realize the importance of your time, you give it up easy for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You start to ensure yourself, it is not just about me, it's about my time so that I can get the best place in Jannah, inshaAllah. إِنَّمَا نُطْعِمُكُمْ لِوَجْهِ اللَّهِ لَا نُرِيدُ مِنْكُمْ جَزَاءً وَلَا شُكُورًا إِنَّا نَخَافُ مِنْ رَبِّنَا يَوْمًا عَبُوسًا قَمْطَرِيرًا. When they say that we feed you, we do whatever we can for you, not waiting for something else to come, but rather to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because we fear a day that is dark and harsh. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us what's the outcome of those people. فَوَقَاهُمُ اللَّهُ شَرَّ ذَلِكَ الْيَوْمِ وَلَقَّاهُمْ نَضْرَةً وَسُرُورًا وَجَزَاهُمْ بِمَا صَبَرُوا جَنَّةً وَحَرِيرًا. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us the blessings of understanding and recognizing the importance of our time and giving it the due responsibility and the due wisdom and awareness. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه غفور رحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه والصلاة والسلام على الحبيب المصطفى وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. My dear brothers and sisters, one of the most important things of understanding the importance of time, this timely worship that the scholars talk about, is for us to have the right balance about doing that which is required of us in the time we are in, as opposed to being worried about what's coming. Now that's not saying that we shouldn't be aware about results and we shouldn't be aware of what the outcome of our activities today are, but sometimes that balance is lost. Because we're constantly thinking, either we're paralyzed by the fact that we have no hope in some ways, that it's too overwhelming, that it's too much, or we are looking into the future but never paying attention to the present. One of the most important exercises of understanding is you do that which is required of you right now, in the best way you can right now. That's when you achieve the real tawakkul, the real balance and understanding that results come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That our role is to align our lives with the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Live Islam to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shall make and shall do whatever He wishes subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's the true balance of understanding that وَمَنْ نَصْرُ إِلَّا مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ. That victory comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That big changes can happen and you'll never appreciate what could happen. But so long as you are fully aware of your time, of your moment, of your responsibility, then you have attained. Allahumma ij'alna sitran liqadarik. Allahumma ista'milna wa la tastabdilna. That's the spirit of understanding that. And lastly, my dear brothers and sisters, this is not without its context. This is not without its reality. So if you want to be true to this worship of ibadatul waqt, then you have to understand your circumstance and your reality. And one of the most challenging things that we collectively have to understand is ما هو واجب الوقت اليوم في أمريكا اليوم في مجتمعنا المسلم في أمريكا وفي العالم ما هو دور المسلم الأمريكي الذي هو جزء من هذه الجالية. What is the role that is compatible with us being in 21st century America, in our society? Can we define what is that wajib? Can we understand it? And I'll give you 6 points quickly because of time, just for us to understand. First, my dear brothers and sisters, we have to make sure that the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Quran and Sunnah, the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is relevant to our reality. When we read the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, hear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speak to us, Most High, Azza wa Jal, then what does that mean in the context of 21st century America? What does that mean in English? What does that mean for us? And it has to be relevant and alive at all times. And it's not for anybody else to define. This is not going to be imported from overseas for us to understand. We have to make sure we do the scholarship and the hard work and the understanding to make that divine guidance relevant to us, for it is for everybody onto this earth. So it's a constant state of scholarship and search that all of us must be engaged in. Secondly, we must raise ourselves, develop ourselves in this guidance, have the self-development and tazkiyah as the constant state that we're in. All of the ibadah, all of the dhikr, all of the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes us better human beings with the highest morals and with the best character. And it has to be a constant process. Thirdly, we must protect our families and our children. We must groom the best building units in a society. Take care of your children. Make them the best in all respects in life. Scholarly, intellectually, morally, spiritually. Groom them, nurture them, prioritize them, and make sure you do the best that you can. Fourthly, we must work as a community. If we want to develop the team that's going to bear that responsibility of honoring Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's guidance, then we must be a community that is deserving of it. Love one another, respect one another, take care of one another, and develop its tools, whether it's the institutions or the financial needs or whatever it takes to make us a vibrant community capable of bringing change and transforming. Fifthly, we must take care of our society. Like it or not, hard or easy, it doesn't matter. We must bear that responsibility. These are our people. Ya qawmi. And prophets came to make sure that they fix their surroundings. And so the poverty and the challenges that we have and the inequities, the injustice, the racism, the problems are our problems. And we must work very hard to figure out how we can join the good, enjoin the good and forbid the evil. And lastly, we are part of a vast ummah and we are part of a humanity that must rise up and must live its standards in accordance with the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So yes, we care about what happens in Masjid al-Aqsa. Yes, we care about what happens to our brothers and sisters in the Rohingya. Yes, we care about the injustice that afflicts Muslims or afflicts any people around the world. And we must do everything we can to ensure that we are neither part of it, nor is our government, nor are we gonna sit silent when we see the transgressions around the world. If we do this, we will live a life, inshallah, that honors the responsibility of time and that would allow us, inshallah, to be closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Lastly, I want to take it from this member to congratulate our community and to congratulate a very dear brother to us, our beloved brother Abdurrahman Al-Amoudi, for his release. Many of you may not know him. Many of you have not interacted with him. But he's a man of this community. And he's a pillar of this community. And many people have not heard of him until he was incarcerated. Because nobody was paying their rent. And nobody was taking care of their families. And nobody was looking after them after he was gone. Alhamdulillah, today or yesterday, he was transferred to a halfway house. And inshallah, he will be with us later today to pray with us the third salah, inshallah. Allahu Akbar. Keep him in your prayers. Do anything you can to help him and his family to rise up after this calamity that has affected him. Forgive him and love him and put him on top of your head and do everything you can, inshallah, to learn from him. And to see, inshallah, the good that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless us with him becoming with us again, inshallah. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for his ease and for his release and for his prosperity, inshallah, and his families, and to reward him for his patience and for the hardship that he has endured. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us and forgive us. اللهم اعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا. أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا اللهم آتي نفوسنا تقواها وزكها مولاي أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها قوموا إلى الصلاة يرحمكم الله وأقم الصلاة.